In the launch, we alluded at the fact that Gaussian elimination performs the same computations as does Lu factorization. However, the algorithm that we simply presented for the Lu factorization was completely unjustified. What we then did do was show that you can morph a simple algorithm that uses loops to compute Gaussian elimination into exactly that algorithm that we had given in the launch. Now let's justify that that indeed computes the Lu factorization. So what is the Lu factorization? The Lu factorization is a matrix L that is unit lower triangular and an upper triangular matrix U, such that if you multiply them together, you get the matrix A back. Okay, that, we call that then the Lu factorization of A, or the Lu decomposition. Okay, so what did we do in the first step of Gaussian elimination? What we did was we exposed that first top left entry, the rest of that row, and then we work with that row to eliminate entries below the diagonal element, to compute multipliers, and to update the rest of the matrix. So the way we can capture that is by saying that A should be partitioned into alpha 1, 1, A 1, 2 transpose, the rest of that first row, the rest of that first column, and the matrix A 2, 2. Okay? Now we can do the same thing for L and U, exposing the top left entry of L, but because it's unit lower triangular, we know that that's a 1, and then we can call the rest of that column L21, and the rest of the matrix L22, and notice that because it's a unit lower triangular matrix, we then have a row of zeros sitting here, and L22 itself is again unit lower triangular. And then we can do the same thing for U, epsilon 1, 1, U12 transpose, a column of zeros, and U22. All right, now, we know what the elements of A are. We would like to compute the elements of L and U, so we need to somehow relate the values in L and U to the entries in A. And the way we're going to do that is by multiplying this product out. How do we do partition matrix-matrix multiplication? Well, it's exactly like multiplying two 2x2 matrices together, except that you do it with the symbols as opposed to with elements, and you can't necessarily commute. Well, not always. So, it's this times that plus this times that. That means that this first entry is epsilon 1, 1. It's this times that plus this times that. That means that the rest of the row is U12 transpose. It's this times that plus this times that. That means we get L times 2, 1 times epsilon 1, 1. And then it is this times that plus this times that. And that gives us L21 times U12 transpose plus L22 times U22. Okay, so now we have another 2x2 blocked matrices. Now, two matrices are equal to each other if their entries are equal to each other. And if you partition two matrices the same way, then the different parts must be equal to each other, the corresponding parts. So what we conclude is that alpha 1, 1 must be equal to epsilon 1, 1. A 1, 2 transpose must be equal to U 1, 2 transpose. A 2, 1 must be equal to L21 times epsilon 11, which by the way we could have written as epsilon 11 times L21 because a vector times a scalar is the same as a scalar times a vector. And finally, A22 is equal to, let's see, L21 times U12 transpose plus L22 times U22. Okay. So what do we conclude? We conclude that epsilon 1, 1 is just equal to alpha 1, 1. And if we are going to overwrite A with L and U, as we have done before, then what it means is that you can leave alpha 1, 1 alone. Similarly, A 1, 2 transpose is just equal to L U 1, 2 transpose. So to compute U 1, 2 transpose and overwrite A 1, 2 transpose with it, you don't need to do anything anyway, either. That's just like when you perform Gaussian elimination, the current row that you're working with, you leave alone. Okay? Next, we're now down here. We know what A21 is. We now know what epsilon 11 is, because it's stored in alpha 11. And therefore, we know that L21 is equal to A21 divided by epsilon 11. However, we would like to overwrite A21 with that. And we recognize that epsilon 11 is now stored in alpha 11. And we get that update. So now we know what L21 is. We know what U12 is. We know what A22 is. And then we can bring this to the other side by subtracting it here and changing this to an equal. And what we notice is that if we update A22 by subtracting off this outer product, performing a rank one update, then what we're left with is having to compute the LU factorization of the result. So in the current step, what we do is we update A22 by subtracting off L21 times U12 transpose, but L21 is stored in A21 and U12 transpose is stored in A12 transpose, and therefore we get that. And then we move on. So in general, what happens is that we have a matrix, we've already processed everything up to this point, and then when we repartition, our alpha 11 appears here and so forth. In the current step, we perform these updates, and then we have computed up to this point, and we move on. And that's how we iterate through. And what you notice is that the resulting algorithm is exactly the algorithm that we presented in the launch, and it's exactly the algorithm that in the end we came up with when we discussed Gaussian elimination and we typeset the resulting algorithm using the flame notation.